Okay, shall we start now? We were discussing the previous year environmental questions, how the questions are being asked in 2018, 2019, 2017 questions. Okay, can you all see me now? Am I audible to you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So we were discussing few questions. Yesterday we have discussed the questions of the 2019 questions. Today we will continue with the remaining questions here. So we were at question number 15, I guess. Yesterday we have discussed question number 15. Yes. In the context of proposal to the use of the hydrogen enriched CNG as fuel for buses in public transport, and consider the following statement. So these questions we have discussed yesterday. Today we will go to the next question. That is question number 15. Recently, there was a growing awareness in our country about the importance of Himalayan metal, because it is found to be sustainable source of. So here you can understand that by going through the questions of UPSC like yesterday and today, we can here understand that there are a few questions which UPSC is asking from the static part, from the static what you can see the concepts and the static material. And some questions they are asking from the current what you can see the developments or current issues or current what you can see the terms which were seen in the news. So question number 15 is a dynamic question. So recently, there was a growing awareness in our country about the importance of Himalayan metal, that is called as Gerardina diversifolia, because it is found to be sustainable source of. Now, whenever such type of what you can see the new plant species or animal species or any what you can see the terms which is coming in the news, which will be having significance or which will be having some importance, whether it is a positive or negative importance, you have to what you can say make a note of it. So few questions will be from the newspaper. Like this question was, it was in the news that Himalayan metal was in the news because it is found to be sustainable source of. So options are, it can be acted as an anti-malarial drug, it can be a sustainable source of the biodiesel or pulp or paper industry, or we can say it is a textile fiber. So you need to know very specific that this Himalayan metal, which is a plant species, which is significant or which is a sustainable source of, whether it acts as an anti-malarial drug or whether it acts as a biodiesel or it helps in paper industry by providing pulp, or it is a textile fiber. So answer is D, that is textile fiber. So such type of questions are like factual. You need to know whether you know it or you don't know it. But if you read newspaper continuously, you know what should be your strategy for such type of question, that you have to read in newspaper for the whole, or you can say the upcoming year. So whenever such type of terms, whenever such type of plants or animal species are coming in the newspaper, they will be asked. So I will give you one example that in 2018 also, there was similar such question. So every year they are asking one such questions, which the plants or animal species, which will be having some significance or which that is negative or positive. Now, what do you think that Himalayan nettle is a positive, what you can say the aspect, or it is a negative aspect of the environment? That which is found to be a sustainable source of textile fiber. So obviously it is a positive thing, right? Am I audible to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So going to the next question. So you got it. So write it down. Next point. The recent plants and animal species which were in the news due to positive or negative, what we can say, the aspect that you need to see. Okay. Now going to the next. That is, which of the following statement are correct about the deposits of methane hydrate? So here we have seen that there was question here that is about the microbeds, right? We have seen yesterday, we have discussed that question, that recently microbeds were seen in the news. Similar such type of questions is also here, right? So methane hydrates, right? So whenever such type of terms are coming in the news, which will be having positive, what you can say, the impact or negative impact on the environment, you need to know. So which of the following statements are correct about the deposits of methane hydrate? So first option is that global warming might trigger the release of the methane gas from these deposits. So we know that methane gas, how the release of the methane gas leads to global warming. Can anybody tell me how the release of the methane gas leads to global warming? I have already discussed this with you. Yes, can anybody tell me how the methane gas can help in global warming? Yes, Ritika.
So by lowering the pressure and by rising the temperature, sir.
how the temperature will rise with the methane gas. You were not there in my earlier class also. Yes.
No,
Sonali, Sonali, can you tell me how the methane gas will lead to increase in the global warming? Okay, Sonali is connecting. Yes, can anybody tell me how the methane gas leads to increase in the global warming? So we have discussed this basic, right? So because we have seen that methane gas is one of the greenhouse gas. Right, so greenhouse gas means what? It can absorb the outgoing solar radiation. So this methane hydrate, like why I'm taking basic, because if suppose news come in the newspaper regarding the methane hydrate, such type of news, so when it says that, whether it is correct or wrong, that's a different thing, but when you are reading such type of news, you need to know the basic, that how the release of the methane gas leads to global warming, because methane gas is a greenhouse gas, and greenhouse gases are those gases which absorb the outgoing solar radiation. So methane hydrate might trigger the release of methane gas, which can lead to global warming. So whether it is correct or not, that you have to find out. Second, large deposits of the methane hydrate are found in Arctic tundra under the sea floor. Where it is found, that you need to see. Then methane in atmosphere oxidizes to carbon dioxide after a decade or two. So methane in atmosphere, that is, oxidizes to carbon dioxide after a decade or two, you need to know about it. But anyways, even if you know, if you don't know all of the, what you can say, the statement, whether they are correct or wrong, but if you know about the first statement or second statement, then you may get the answer by, what you can say, checking the options. So can anybody have seen this term in the news? What are methane hydrates? Anyone has read? Yes or no? Okay, fine. So if anybody has not read it, then obviously, because this question was of 2019, so those who were reading newspaper continuously or regularly from 2017 onwards, they might have read it. But now forget about methane hydrate. But suppose if such type of term, such type of substances, which is there, which is coming in the newspaper, what you need to do, what is the significance of that, what is the negative or positive of that, where they are found, and what is the, what you can say, the how they react with the, what you can say, the other chemical elements of the atmosphere, that you need to check it out, right? So here you can see that answer is D, that is 1, 2, and 3, all are correct. So global warming might trigger the release of the methane gas. This is correct. Second statement is also correct, and third statement is also correct. Fine. So what do you understand? Ki aisa agar koi term newspaper mein aa raha hai, aisa agar koi chemical substance hai jo environment ko harmful ho sakta hai, ya फिर ऐसा कोई प्लांट है, एनिमल है जो एनवायरमेंटली सस्टेनेबल है, ऐसा अगर कुछ न्यूज़पेपर में आता है, तो यू हैव टू मेक अ नोट ऑफ इट. सो फॉर द अपकमिंग ईयर, लाइक सपोज इफ यू आर गिविंग एग्जाम इन 2021, सो जब तक एग्जाम नहीं आता है, जब तक एग्जाम होती है, तब तक आपको क्या करना है, यू हैव टू मेक अ सेपरेट सेक्शन फॉर यूर, व्हाट यू कैन से, एनवायरमेंट एंड इकोलॉजी, एंड यू हैव टू नोट ऑल दोस, व्हाट यू कैन से, द टर्म्स व्हिच आर कमिंग इन द न्यूज़पेपर, एंड दैट इज व्हाई यू हैव टू रीड न्यूज़पेपर रेगुलरली बाय योरसेल्फ. Don't rely on any material which is available in the market, because the material which are available in the market, they might be skipping such type of, what you can say, information, or wo bahut zyada de sakte hain, like jo relevant nahi hai UPSC ke liye, wo bhi usme aa jayega. So it would be a kind of, what you can say, the time waste for you if you read such material which are available in the what you can say, market. So I normally I always say that you should have your own notes for science and tech, ecology and economy, and that notes should be according to the recent trends of the exam, that on how, what is the recent trend. Fine. Then going to the next question. In India, the use of carbofuran, methyl parathion, ferrite and triazofos is viewed with apprehension. Apprehension means, again, it is negative. So the use of carbofuran, methyl parathion, ferrite and triazofos is viewed with apprehension. These chemicals are used as. So anyone, किसी ने इसमें से कोई एक word को सुना है? Like now, can you tell me why UPSC has not asked a question like the use of ferrite was seen in the news recently? So this, what is ferrite? ऐसा question UPSC ने क्यों नहीं पूछा? What do you think? Why the UPSC has not asked this question? कि why not only ferrite? Why they have asked carbofuran, methyl parathion, or triazofos? What should be the psychology behind giving four names, and why not only one chemical? yes yes because UPSC is not working is not is becoming very specific ki aapko 48 pata hona chahiye is charon mein se agar ek bhi agar aapko pata hai it means you are an aware person that is what UPSC is expecting you samajh mein aaya so kisi ne suna hai carbofuran methyl pyrethone aur forate और ट्राइजोफॉस ये वर्ड में ये जो केमिकल्स है ये कहाँ यूज होते हैं किसी ने सुना है ये चारों में से कोई नहीं नहीं सुना है
सर मेथियोन आई थिंक आई हैव हर्ड इट बट आई एम नॉट श्योर
सो व्हाट इट इज लाइक इट इज अ पेस्टिसाइड इन एग्रीकल्चर और प्रिजर्वेटिव्स इन प्रोसेस्ड फूड सी हियर यू कैन सी इट इज एन अप्रिहेंशन सो अप्रिहेंशन मींस इट इज नेगेटिव सो पेस्टिसाइड्स इन एग्रीकल्चर प्रिजर्वेटिव्स इन प्रोसेस्ड फूड्स and fruit ripening agents so and last is the moisturizing agents in the cosmetics but anyways forate is one such what we can see the thing which anyone should know it forate is actually a pesticide which is used what you can say to kill the pest on the plants so ye agar aapko pata hai to answer nikal sakta but anyways answer is a here agar aapko pata bhi nahi hai to it's no problem but अभी आपको क्या करना है व्हाट यू हैव टू डू इन द फ्यूचर नाउ कि व्हेनेवर सच टाइप ऑफ केमिकल सब्सटेंसेस वेदर इट इज अ पेस्टिसाइड वेदर इट इज प्रिजर्वेशन प्रिजर्वेटिव इन द प्रोसेस्ड फूड्स और फूड राइपनिंग एजेंट्स और मॉइस्चराइजिंग एजेंट्स इन कॉस्मेटिक्स बिकॉज़ यू सी एवरी ईयर लाइक दे आर आस्किंग क्वेश्चंस ऑन ऑल दिस लाइक सम इन 2016 दे हैव क्वेश्चन दे हैव आस्क्ड देम क्वेश्चंस रिलेटेड टू द प्रिजर्वेटिव्स और व्हिच आर यूज्ड इन द प्रोसेस्ड फूड्स राइट because you know there was a controversy related to Maggi that there are some chemical substances which are used in Maggi so the question was asked related to that there was one more question related to the one substance which is used in the Chinese what you can say the food not anyone remember I have already discussed this with you that is there is one and chemical
Ajinomoto sir yes
yeah,
sir
Ajinomoto but Ajinomoto is a common word but what is the chemical word for the Ajinomoto
sodium glutamate
sensitive but not sure about the
it is sodium glutamate yeah so glutamate. That question was asked right so one year the question have been asked related to the preservatives which are used in the food, processed food then fruit ripening then moisturizing agents and it is a pesticide so again you got it so in coming year like if you are giving exam in 2021 or 2022 तो जब तक आपका एग्जाम नहीं होता है तब तक ऐसे जो भी वर्ड्स न्यूज़पेपर में आ रहे हैं वो आपको देखना है विच आर हार्मफुल टू द एनवायरनमेंट दैट इज व्हाट इज एक्सपेक्टेड यू डोंट नीड टू बी व्हाट यू कैन से द उसमें ज्यादा आपको पीएचडी नहीं करना है जो न्यूज़पेपर में आ रहा है वही आपको नोट डाउन करके रखना है सो हियर आई नो अबाउट फॉरेट बिकॉज फॉरेट इज यूज एज अ पेस्टिसाइड ये मुझे पता था सो ऑन दैट बेसिस आई कैन फाइंड आउट द आंसर दैट इज पेस्टिसाइड इन एग्रीकल्चर फाइंड इट सो इट इज नॉट नेसेसरी कि आपको ये चारों पता हो इसमें से अगर कोई एक भी अगर आपको पता है तो आप एग्जाम में आंसर निकाल सकते हैं और यूपीएससी फ्रेम सच क्वेश्चंस दे फ्रेम क्वेश्चंस इन सच अ मैनर दैट बाय हैविंग अ जनरल अवेयरनेस यू विल बी एबल टू फाइंड आउट द आंसर ऑफ द क्वेश्चंस गॉट इट चेक इट गोइंग टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन देयर वर टोटल 18 क्वेश्चंस इन 2019 प्रीलिम्स एग्जाम इट इज द लास्ट क्वेश्चन एज आई टोल्ड यू दैट एवरी ईयर देयर इज अ क्वेश्चन ऑन द रामसर कन्वेंशन और व्हाट यू कैन से ऑन द प्रोटेक्टेड साइट्स at the international level so consider the following statements about the Ramsar convention those who have read the Ramsar convention because as we know that the questions have been asked from the Ramsar convention every year then aapko padhna chahiye aur jisne padha tha usko answer aayega because even 2017 also there was a question on Ramsar convention in 2016 there was a question on Ramsar convention in 2015 also there was a question on Ramsar convention so if it is a trend you have to read it if the question has been already asked on some points of the Ramsar convention so next year the question will be on the left out what you can say the points of the Ramsar convention got it so we will see what is the question how the question is being framed under Ramsar convention it is mandatory on the part of the government of India to protect and conserve all the wetlands in territory of India so what is this under the Ramsar convention it is mandatory on the part of the government of India to protect and conserve all the wetlands in the territory of India so what do you think the statement is correct or wrong or why, what could be the likely mistakes in the statement or the statement is correct read it carefully under the Ramsar convention it is mandatory on the part of the government of India to protect and conserve all the wetlands in the territory of India So what do you think? The statement correct or wrong?
Wrong.
Wrong. Why you feel it is wrong?
Wrong, sir.
Why?
So because it is saying all, it should be international importance.
Okay. Fine. चलिए अभी आपको थोड़ा सा question from मेरी की psychology समझ में आ रही है. Yes, Gitanjali, why you think why it is wrong? Same reason or any other reason?
Yes, sir. The importance they hello.
Yes, I can hear you, Gitanjali. Continue.
Sir, they see the importance of that wetland and that after that they came under the Ramsar Convention.
Okay, so not all wetlands in India are supposed to be protected by the government of India under Ramsar Convention. Fine.
So this sentence might be, this sentence might be false.
Okay, fine. Okay, anyone else? Can anybody wants to give inputs about this statement?
Sir, it is not mandatory. It is voluntary.
It is voluntary. It is not mandatory. It is voluntary. Okay, so here there is one more term. It is mandatory. Fine. ठीक है. Anything else?
Sir, और अगर हमें ये भी पता है कि जो हमारी wetlands हैं वो Ramsar sites में जैसे क्योंकि वो ज़्यादा number में भी नहीं है, तो if we know के only two sites are limited, तो we can say कि all तो नहीं होगा क्योंकि सिर्फ दो ही sites हमारी listed है.
ठीक है. चलिए, तो आप जैसे जो students हैं जिन्होंने बहुत पढ़ाई की है तो उनके लिए ये पता है, बट जिनको नहीं पता है वो भी फाइंड आउट कर सकते हैं. That is what I mean to say. And आपको पता है तो that's fine. So you will be very sure about it कि the first statement is wrong. But even if you like, it's not only about only Ramsar Convention. अगर ऐसा कोई भी अगर दूसरे टॉपिक पे या कंसेप्ट पे अगर क्वेश्चन आता है, तो पहले तो आप क्या करोगे, अगर आपको पता भी नहीं है तो आप क्या करोगे, यू विल ट्राई टू फाइंड आउट, यू विल रीड द स्टेटमेंट. जितना भी आपको पता है उसके बेसिस पे आप कर सकते हो. अब यहाँ पर यह है कि ये मैंडेटरी वर्ड है और यहाँ पे ऑल है, तो जितना हमने अभी बेसिक देखा है तो ऐसे नहीं है कि जितने भी इंटरनेशनल जो कन्वेंशन होते हैं, most of the convention are not what you can say mandatory, they are voluntary, because all the countries are voluntarily trying to what you can say protect the environment and what you can say the forest. Am I right? Okay. Next, the wetlands conservation and management rules 2010. So ye aapko dekhna padega obviously. So under Ramsar convention, to ek wetlands ko management karne ke liye rules banaye hain. To humne dekha ki we have to go and check it out, what are the rules framed by the government of India, that wetlands conservation and management rules 2010 were framed by the government of India based on the recommendations of Ramsar convention. To aapko kya lagta hai, ye statement sahi hai ya galat hai? Jo bhi wetland conservation aur management ke jo rules hain wo Ramsar convention ke recommendation ke hisab se banaye honge, to what do you think, statement is like it looks positive or it looks negative? Ho sakta hai. Am I right? It might be true.
Yes.
There is nothing negative in it, right? It might be quite possibility that government may have made a rule as per the recommendation of the Ramsar Convention, because Ramsar Convention is an international, what you can say, followed convention for the protection of the wetlands. Third, the Wetlands Conservation and Management Rule 2010 also encompass the drainage area or catchment regions of the wetlands as determined by the authority. So what do you think, sir? Third statement, jisme kuch wrong hone ke chances hai, is there any chances of get like there is something wrong in this statement? Theek hai.
No.
Then we will go for the this option then. So options are 1 and 2 only, 2 and 3 only, and 3 only. So what do you think? 1 only to nahi hoga, because as we have already eliminated the option 1, so ye option to nahi hoga. 2 or 3 ho sakta hai, ya 3 only bhi ho sakta hai, but why 3 only is wrong? Why C is wrong? Because we have seen,
sir,
that
you are not audible, the voice is glitching in between.
Is it okay now? Hello.
Yes, sir.
So why why the option B is wrong, sorry, why the option, C is wrong? Why 3 only is wrong? Pramod, to the hotspot on, kar. Am I audible now? Hello?
Yeah.
Okay. So why do you think why option 3 is wrong? sorry, that is C is wrong.
So C is right, na?
No.
So C, basically.
See, three only.
So because both are talking about the conservation and management rules 2010. So either two or three, either of one cannot be the option.
Sir, I think both are correct because I have read it somewhere that second option was also there.
So what should be the answer here? Two and three only or three only?
Sir, I think two and three only.
So we will just go and check it out to Wetlands Conservation Management Rule 2003, whether the, what you can say, the rules framed under this management are according to the Ramsar Convention or not. Fine. So we will confirm it. So here it is, the Environment Wetland Rules. First, again, you need to also see the source. Your website, whether it is a government website or any other website that we need to do. But anyways, here you can see, yes. So wetlands refer to the transitional areas between the terrestrial and aquatic ecosystem. In the wetlands, land may be covered by shallow water or the water table is usually at or near the surface. It is an area of marsh, peatland or water, permanent or temporary with water and... water which is either static or flowing, fresh or brackish in the inland and coastal areas. It includes lakes, reserves. What is wetland? Wetland rules 2003. The central government has officially identified 115 wetlands in India. In India, there are around 26 wetlands identified under the Ramsar Convention. So you have to go and check it out, which are those 26 identified wetlands under the Ramsar Convention 1971. So not all wetlands are identified under the Ramsar Convention. That government has identified 115. Out of that 115, 26 have been, what you can say, identified under the Ramsar Convention in 1971. So Ramsar Convention is an international treaty signed in 1971 to ensure wetland protection, wetland conservation. So the checking here for an exam, the Ashtamudi wetland in Kerala, Bhitarkanika and Chilka Lake in Odisha, Kolleru Lake in Andhra Pradesh are famous wetlands of India. So check it. Rules.
So secondly, but based on Ramsar Convention, nahi hai, baki formed by to hai government of India, Ministry of Environment, Forest, Climate Change.
No, that is good. Whether it is based on the Ramsar Convention or not, that is what we need to take into the check, right? So that is what I'm confirming. Now we need to confirm it. Okay, do one thing. If anyone is having the official answer key of 2019, we will see about it. But anyways, kya hona chahiye ki? I think one second. Ye jo wetland regulations jo frame jo kiye hue hain, the rules about the management and conservation of the wetland, it should be as per the recommendation of the Ramsar Convention. I say to hona chahiye ideally, but let's see why the Jagran Joshi has said that the second statement is wrong. We need to check, but anyways, when the official answer key will come, we will see. Ideally, mujhe aisa lagta hai ki 2 and 3 hona chahiye, but maybe possibility ye bhi aise bhi ho sakti hai ki specifically Ramsar Convention ke hisab se na ho, but we will see the official answer key or I will check it out, the official, what you can say, the wetland conservation and management rules, and then we'll check it about it whether it is or not. But anyways, so ideally to aise hona chahiye ki second statement should also be correct. Check it. So these were the questions of the 2018 exam, right? So now, sorry, 2019 exam, this was the previous year exam. So official answer key is still not declared. So once the official answer key is declared, you will all go and check it out, what is the official answers of this all these questions. Got it? Ye aapko dekhna hai, because kya hota hai ki many a times, not like most of the time, what happens ki the answer given by these portals or any classes, they are also wrong. So it is not necessary ki they might be correct. So you have to go and check it out, confirm what is the correct answer. Okay, now going to the 2018 question. So in 2018 there were total 11 questions. Again, we will see that how, why I am discussing 2018 questions now. We will see how the topics are repeated, how the areas are repeated. Questions may be different, but the topics and areas are same. So on that basis, we can say make a list of the topics on which the UPSC is repeatedly asking the question. So it would be more helpful for you to have a focused revision, right? Instead of rather than reading what you can say, बहुत ज़्यादा material पढ़ने से क्या होगा कि यहाँ पर आपको ये पता चलेगा कि हमको focusedly कौन से topics हमको पढ़ना है. Fine. So next question. With reference to the genetically modified mustard developed in the following in developed in the India, consider the following statement. So as we have seen that there is at least one question related to the genetically modified, what you can say, the organisms in India. So these questions may be related to what you can say, the environment, or it may be related to general science, because in general science there is one topic called biotechnology. So it is a mixture of both. So with reference to the genetically modified mustard, that is called a GM mustard, developed in India, consider the following statement. So this was in the news, that GM mustard was in the news. Last 4-5 years it is in the news. It is still in the news. There are many questions or news are coming in the newspaper related to the GM mustard. So genetically modified mustard. So can anybody tell me what is the meaning of this genetically modified mustard? Basic cheez bataiye mujhe, what is the meaning of genetically modified mustard? मस्टर्ड तो सबको पता है. व्हाट इज मस्टर्ड सबको पता है. ऑल ऑफ यू नो व्हाट इज मस्टर्ड.
यस सर.
राइट. बट देयर इज अ मॉडिफिकेशन इन दैट मस्टर्ड. व्हाट काइंड ऑफ मॉडिफिकेशन. जेनेटिकल मॉडिफिकेशन. सो दैट जेनेटिकल मॉडिफिकेशन मे बी व्हाट यू कैन से टू इंक्रीज द प्रोडक्टिविटी, और इट मे बी टू व्हाट यू कैन से पेस्ट रेजिस्टेंट, और इट मे बी फॉर व्हाट यू कैन से टू यूज लेस वाटर. Like, कुछ भी चेंज किया जा सकता है, तो उसको मॉडिफाइड, जेनेटिकली मॉडिफाइड मस्टर्ड कहा जाता है. सो वी हैव सीन दैट रिसेंटली मेनी सच क्रॉप्स आर बीइंग जेनेटिकली मॉडिफाइड, लाइक बीटी कॉटन, बीटी ब्रिंजल, जीएम मस्टर्ड. देयर आर वेरियस वैरायटीज ऑफ द शुगर, व्हाट यू कैन से शुगर केन, दे आर जेनेटिकली मॉडिफाइड. दीज आर कॉल्ड एज हाइब्रिड वैरायटीज, राइट. सो इवन द टोमेटो वैरायटीज हैव आल्सो बीन, व्हाट यू कैन से, वेरीफाइड, व्हाट यू कैन से, दे हैव बीन मॉडिफाइड नाउ. So genetically modified mustard was in the news in 2016, and that is why the question was asked. तो अभी आपको क्या करना है कि if in the coming year, if any such genetically modified crop has been developed, then you have to go what is the significance of that genetically modified crops, what changes have been made, and how it is going to benefit, and what are the advantage and what are the disadvantage of that genetically modified crop, that you need to check it out. Fine. Yes, Zain.
सर वो इसमें जीएमओ के अंदर एनिमल्स का भी जीन यूज करते हैं ऐसा सुना था मैं.
जीएम क्रॉप्स में सी जीएमओ मींस वेजिटेबल. नो नो सी जीएमओ मतलब क्या होता है, जेनेटिकली मॉडिफाइड ऑर्गेनिज्म. द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ जीएमओ इज जेनेटिकली मॉडिफाइड ऑर्गेनिज्म. सो इन ऑर्गेनिज्म इट मे बी प्लांट, इट मे बी एनिमल्स, और इट मे बी अ बैक्टीरिया ऑल्सो, बिकॉज ऑर्गेनिज्म में सब कुछ आता है. वेरी so when we refer something as a GMO, it means genetically modified organism. So it may be a plant or it may be animal. Now you are saying ki some of the genes of the animals are used in plants, that's what you are asking, right? You are saying, right?
Yes sir.
Yes, maybe aisi koshish to chal rahi hogi ki animals ke jo genes hai wo plants mein matlab usko wo kare, but I don't think ki abhi filhal to wo waise koi technology abhi tak aayi hogi jisme like agar animals ke jo genes hai wo plants mein use ho jaye, but there may be research is going on, may be possibility.
So sir, abhi jo bhi use kar raha hai to uske side effects bhi hain to sir?
Yes of course, side effects are also there. That is what I am saying ki aapko kya karna hai ki koi bhi aisa genetically modified crop ya plants agar koi develop kiya jata hai to wo kaun sa hai, uska significant kya hai, uske positives kya hai aur uske negatives kya hai, wo dono aapko dekhna hai. Because now the questions have been already asked about the GM mustard. Questions cannot be asked about the GM mustard now. But जो भी पूरे साल भर में अगर कोई ऐसा नया, अगर कोई genetically modified organism या genetically modified plant अगर develop किया जाता है, तो आपको देखना है. अगर नहीं कोई बना है उस साल, it is not necessary कि हर साल कोई genetically modified crop develop ही हो जाए. ऐसे भी नहीं है. ऐसे crop बनाने में सालों लगते हैं ना. It takes like 10-15 years to develop a proper what you can say genetically modified organism. और जेनेटिकली मॉडिफाइड क्रॉप्स. सो अगर उस साल में कोई अगर नहीं बना है तो छोड़ दीजिए. यस देन. हेलो ज़ैन, यू वांट टू आस्क समथिंग?
नो सर.
चेक. ओके. सो हाउ द क्वेश्चंस आर फ्रेम्ड ऑन सच टाइप ऑफ टॉपिक. that GM mustard has the genes of soil bacterium that give the plant a property of pest resistance to a wide variety of pests. अब यहाँ पे क्या पूछा गया है, देखो जो वो जो जेनेटिकली मॉडिफाइड ऑर्गेनिज्म है, जो क्रॉप है, उसका सिग्निफिकेंस क्या है? So GM mustard has genes of soil bacterium that give the plant the property of pest resistance to the wide variety of pests. So you need to know whether this statement is correct. So likely mistakes क्या हो सकता है कि यहाँ पर जो property है, whether it is a pest resistant or something else, that you need to know. Fine. Anybody knows what is GM mustard and what is the what changes have been made in the GM mustard and how it is helping in the increase in the production of the mustard? Is it a pest resistant? Check it. We will check it out. Actually, it is not a pest resistant. Anyone knows? Oh, GM mustard mein kya changes banaye gaye the? Bikisha, do you know?
So
yeah, one second.
So it is basically a self-pollinating plant, but then I think hybrid helps it to cross-pollinate.
Okay, so let us see what is let us see. See why I'm asking this to you, because it helps in in understanding how the questions are being framed. So ये जो statement जो बनाया गया है, कैसे question framer ने इस question को इस statement को frame किया है आपको समझ में आ जाएगा. While seeing what is the significance of GM mustard. See again. Questions may not be repeated about the GM mustard, but it will help us in understanding how the questions are being framed. So here you can see, one second, can you all see the screen? Is it visible to all of you? Okay, in Wikipedia you can say DMH 11 mustard. Okay, can you all see the Wikipedia?
No, okay.
Is it fine now?
Yes.
Can you all see the screen now? Wikipedia?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So Dhara mustard hybrid 11. That is the what you can say modified hybrid variety which has been developed now. So it's a genetically modified hybrid variety of mustard species Brassicea juncea. It was developed by Professor Deepak Panchal from University of Delhi with the aim of reducing India's demand for edible oil import. So question have been already asked about it. India एडिबल ऑयल को इंपोर्ट करता है क्या? यस, वी इंपोर्ट अ लॉट द एडिबल ऑयल बिकॉज़ एडिबल ऑयल का प्रोडक्शन इंडिया में उतना ज्यादा नहीं है. सो यस्टरडे वी हैव सीन वन आर्टिकल अबाउट ऑफ द अशोक गुलाटी इन द इंडियन एक्सप्रेस. सो डू यू रिमेंबर दैट इन इंडियन एक्सप्रेस अशोक गुलाटी हैज आस्क्ड फॉर ही हैज गिवन अ स्ट्रेटजी कि इंस्टेड ऑफ गोइंग फॉर राइस एंड व्हाट यू कैन से शुगर वी शुड गो फॉर सम अदर इकोनॉमिकली वैल्यूएबल व्हाट यू कैन से द क्रॉप्स राइट. So edible oil एक सबसे option है, where the palm oil हमने देखा था, या suggested for palm oil, right? Anyways, so DMH was created through transgenic technology primarily involving the bark. ठीक है, what it helps? The insertion of the third gene bark enables the to produce this enzyme.